I hope that you are safe and healthy. So let's begin with the session. So aviation industry is the business sector that manufactures, maintains, and operates the aircrafts and the airports. When it comes to aviation, there is a broad range of responsibilities within it. It comprises activities at the airport as well as in the aircraft. Let's know about why are we using this word aviation. Let's note that what aviation means. Aviation management is an activity of planning, designing, operating, and maintaining airports and aircrafts. What is aviation management? Aviation is a field that undergoes frequent. So aviation management, again, it is an activity planning, designing, operating, and maintaining aircrafts and airport. Let's know about the IT department, which is the division of aviation management. So aviation is a field that undergoes frequent changes. This industry works 24/7, hence there is a change in manpower, resources, and the aircraft too. The information technology is playing an instrumental role in the success of aviation. Right from the simulation software the trainee pilots use, here are some of the various software used by the staff of the aviation industry. Aircraft maintenance software, which keeps the tracks of the on-floor activities of maintenance. Then we have fuel management software that optimizes fuel procurement and reacts to the fluctuation in fuel price. The third is network and route performance management software that anticipates profitable air routes and enables quick decision making. Next is catering procurement software that helps in carrying out the entire procure-to-pay procedure seamlessly. Number fifth is catering production software, which emphasizes minimum waste and maximum customer satisfaction. Then we have flight information display system at software at the airports works round the clock in real time to display the detailed flight status such that the travelers can get to know the latest information from any corner of the airport as well as on the internet. Next is department control software, which works in junction with the reservation system to keep the track of check-in travelers and issues boarding passes. So there are numerous mobile apps the customers use for checking flight times, booking flights, redeeming points against fare, and mobile checking in. Thus, IT plays an important role in ensuring the smooth functioning of aviation operations. Next comes the finance department, the finance management. So, airline financial management is a multifaceted, challenging task. Selecting and implementing the right solution for cash management is the key challenge the airlines often face. Today, many airlines are availing treasury management system that provides finance handling solutions. Now, the following are the four basic factors in airline finance management. The income statement. It is a report that shows business managers and investors whether the airline made or lost money during the specific period. Second is cash flow statement. It provides information on cash receipts and payments and the net change in cash due to operating, investing, and financing activities of an airline during the period. Next, stakeholders. Equity statement. It is a record of the current equity stake held by the airline's investors. Next is balance sheet. It gives an idea about the financial position of the airlines at a given point of time. It reflects what the airline owns as well as how much it owes. Fuel and currency hedging. So, airlines are extremely exposed to the changes in aviation fuel or jet fuel costs. A slightest change in the fuel price can affect the airline business, finance, and operations. To deal with fuel price changes, the airlines use a tool named fuel hedging. Now let's know what fuel hedging is. It is a contract that the airlines use to protect themselves from the changes and rise in fuel rates. The cost of fuel hedging depends on the forecasted price of fuel. The airlines enter into hedging contracts with fuel companies to establish a fixed price of the fuel. In future, if the fuel price increases, then their contracted price, the airline is forced to pay the contracted price. If the price of the fuel decreases than the current fuel price, then the airline receives the price difference from the fuel company. Who provides fuel hedging services? The fuel management companies, oil companies, and financial service companies provide fuel hedging services to the airlines. For example, World Fuel Service, British Petroleum, Morgan Stanley, and BNP Paribas. The next division is route planning. Route planning is nothing but planning on the proposed route for flights. It involves the calculation of amount of fuel required for an aircraft to travel from the original airport to the destination airport. The route planning involves plan of flight with adequate amount of fuel and most reasonable route. Compliance of the flight with air traffic control requirements. Various plans includes summary plan for the air traffic control. Summary plan for direct download into onboard flight management system. And detailed plan for the use by pilots. So, I talked about this. Next is flight management in airline marketing. Detailed plan for the use by pilots. Flight management system. Flight management system is an electronic system that navigates an aircraft according to the flight plan. Flight plans are prepared by pilots or other professional dispatchers before departure and they are entered into flight management system. Flight management system also contains navigation database that contains all relevant information required to execute the flight plan. What is air traffic control service? The air traffic control service assists the airlines to ensure their safe and orderly operations in real time. The ATS is responsible for preventing aircraft collisions, providing aid for the safe and efficient conduct of flights, carry out and maintain an orderly flow of air traffic, and notify concerned organization and assist in search and rescue operations of aircrafts. Next division is aviation management airline marketing. Airline is part of the travel and tourism service industries, where rivals compete to offer the best experience in spite of similar end products. Unlike organizations that sell tangible products such as cars, stationery, or food brands, the airlines sell elite experience to their customers. The experience that they provide to the customer is intangible as well as invisible. Airline marketing environment. The airlines find out insights of the marketing environment using a powerful model of analysis called the pest analysis. So this is the model of the pest analysis. The field of marketing comes with a useful model for the study of an organization's marketing environment. This model proposes that the factors should be categorized into political, economic, social, and technological. This model turns up a reliable for the airline industry to understand market growth or decline, business position, and direction for operations. So, let's discuss the political factors. Political factors include fear of terrorism, political instability in the country, deregulation of the government policies. The next is economic factors, economic growth or instability in the country. Social factors includes aging population, change in holidaying tastes, change in family structures, uncertain labor. Fourth is technological factors, high speed electronic devices, fuel efficient aircrafts, internet. Next is airline marketing on social media. So airline marketing on social media, all the airlines around the world understand that today's customer are tuned to internet almost all the time. Hence, the airlines tend to make a striking presence on internet. The airlines are leveraging ways to reach their customers using social media. Let's take the example of the showcased picture on the screen. This is the Cathay Pacific Airways. They have created a Facebook page to display deals, promotions, limited period offers, and videos about the airlines. Qatar Airways has a strong presence on Twitter with sharing news events, upselling, and conveying the information on how the company is doing. Another example is Turkish Airlines, which is marketing policy depends on using hashtags for building relevance and authenticity, where Emirates is using Instagram. Maintaining presence on social media is a 24/7 work for which the airlines hire people who know business strategies, write powerful content, and have the know-how of brand positioning. Next comes the airport planning and development. It involves the planning, designing, and construction of terminals, runways, and other ancillary facilities for airlines to operate. Developing an airport requires huge amount of capital and anticipation of future growth of airlines and passengers. Now, airport designing. Airport projects are involved with many considerations and issues. Hence, they are highly collaborative. Designing of airport is taken by up architectural firms. The architects works in collaboration with civil engineers to come up with the airport layout plans. The experts come up with the master plans, which is referred for further developments. Planning an airport. To plan an airport, the concerned three approvals. So technical approvals, which includes the review and approve airport layout plan, then review and acceptance of forecast, and then airspace and procedure changes. Land acquisitions. The next is financial approvals. This includes the funding for the airport is approved once the project gets clearance for safety, security, capacity, and airport access systems. Environmental approvals. Review and assess environmental issues. Find out solution to address the environmental problems. The next is airport planning. The following criteria need to be considered while planning and designing a terminal. Passenger flow and traffic peaking, minimum walking distance, level of service for passenger and sophistication, performance standards, area for retailers like duty-free shops, food joints and spas. Area for facilities, points such as restrooms, ATM machines, and kiosks. Easy access to retail area and facility points. Compatibility of facilities with aircraft characteristics. Ability to handle changes in technology and automation. Expandability for future growth. Terminal configuration. So this is the terminal configuration. You can see that how the terminals are designed for and for the airplanes to stand. So standard linear, if I talk about, then the airport's Detroit Metropolitan Airport is confining to the standard linear layout configuration. The next is curvilinear. So we have example of Munich Airport. The next is Spire, the Amsterdam and Chitos Airport, Japan, and Los Angeles, which are confiding with the Spire configuration. Then we have Concourse. So Atlanta International Airport, Al Maktoum International Airport, Dubai, and Ohio International Airport, Chicago. Then we have Star Terminal, Star Pyre, so Geneva Airport, Switzerland, Orlando International Airport, Florida. So now next is aviation safety. Aviation risks and threats are a part of the daily operation of the aviation industry. They can put passenger to face time delays, price hikes, uncertainty, or even the loss of life. Though it uses radars which spots intrusion into the controlled airspace and other navigational aids, the aircrafts face threats of losing its path. Today, though a large number of instruments and aviation operations accurately in real time, aviation business is prone to hazards, risks, and threats. Since numerous passengers travel by air frequently, there are objections related to risk, vulnerabilities, and threats. So, risk in aviation, it is potential loss or damage of property, information, or lives, which is also assets that can happen due to threat. Literally, there is a risk of it if the assets, vulnerabilities, and threats are present altogether. So, the common aviation risks are: aviation risks include operational, strategic, compliance, and financial risks that then put the assets into problems. There can be several types of risk for aircraft as well as airport. Bad weather conditions for flying aircraft. Aircraft about to run out of the fuel while in flight. A person in the aircraft or airport needs medical aid critically. Failure of electrical, electronics, or mechanical components. Pilot's mistake. Bird strike at the time of aircraft movement. An inexperienced employee or unknown person at the airport. Unscreened passengers on their articles allowed to board the aircraft. The next is vulnerability in aviation. So vulnerability is weakness or a loophole in the security system. A threat can take undue advantage of vulnerability to breach the security and destroy assets. Common aviation vulnerabilities are, so like the access to airside area of the airport to non-traveler, non-staff people, poor screening methods for passengers and baggage, poor aircraft or airport management, overcrowding adjacent gates at the time of departure, poor security in handling information regarding flight plan. So the next is threats in aviation. A threat is a particular source of attack. We cannot forget the most notorious and perilous 9/11 attack, where four airliners were hijacked to carry out a suicidal attack on World Trade Center and Pentagon. So common aviation threats includes the unattended or unclaimed baggage found at airport, a person carrying weapon without declaration, a person not cooperating with the security staff, a person carrying sharp objects with him, a call from an unknown person for destruction, a person with suspicious gestures and appearance. So these are all the risks which are faced in aviation domain. So this is the department which look into the matters of risk meticulously. The next is safety and security in aviation. The airport security systems and staff together work towards the safety of the airport, the aircraft, and also the safety of the passengers. To manage the airport as well as the aircraft security, there are measures which are employed. So aircraft and airports employees are trained on security and safety issues as well as crisis handling procedures. Aircrafts are equipped with emergency exit way and procedures for passengers. Airport areas are monitored by closed circuit TV cameras. A dedicated team of trained police force is employed for airport and aircraft safety. The security staff takes the help of sniffer dogs to detect any unclaimed object lying around the airport. The airport are equipped with firefighting alarm and fire extinguishing systems. Sensitive airside areas in airports such as ramps and operational spaces and restricted areas from the general public. Every traveler who arrives at the airport needs to enter into airport only from the departure entry. The traveler can go in further only after showing a valid journey ticket, an identity proof, and a passport if required. Non-passengers need to obtain a gate pass and face security checking to enter the secure area of airport. Traveler check-in baggage and handbags are strictly screened through X-ray machines. Travelers are screened by metal detectors before they board, but they can be subjected to later screening if required. Travelers are not permitted to enter the cockpit area of the aircraft. The food joints at the airport use containers and glasses made of plastic instead of those made of glass, as they can be used as weapons. So, thank you everyone for being a patient audience, and this was Sunil Sharma signing off as the host.